Kamaldeen Abdullahi is a national Nasarawa coordinator of the MPP. He was part of a team that recently toured the United States of America, and they interacted with various opinion leaders as well as supporters of the MPP among the Ghanaian community. It was something that was very incisive, very much displayed on social media. We say you're welcome back to Ghana.
Well, it's thank good. You, Roland.
How were the interactions?
Well, good, pretty good, pretty good. We actually went to witness our first ever international conference for the youth of the party. And it's first of its kind, actually. And I believe that it's going to be annually repeated. So as we can get the youth in the party getting interactive, getting to know each other, getting to share ideas, getting to formulate, as it were, shadow policies that if Allah willing we come to power, we're going to have a very excellent form of governance. We are not a party that sits down to wait for power to be given to you and you have no direction. So basically we try to orient our youths to get them on board. And of course, looking at me, you should know that I belong to the youth as well. So some of these matters come. I was there with Samuel Oku, I was there with Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia, I was there with a couple of others in the party, some MPs, Status Glover and co. We're all together. It was quite a very successful program, actually.
Mm. And whilst you were there, the Rise and Build Tour also was taking place in Accra.
Absolutely. Is there, you know, the road to attaining the authority to govern is quite huge, you know, and we can all be at the same place at the same time. While others are doing this, others are also engaging that, or others are also in this form of practice and all that, all leading to one channel, that is attaining power for Ghana and also ensuring that Ghana is given the mark of good governance that we need.
Mm. And prior to that, the MPP, they convened a press conference and raised questions about Ghana's electoral register. And following that, they had a number of the parties also raising concerns, and ultimately meeting the Electoral Commission through the Inter-Party Advisory Committee, that is IPAC. And as a result, the Electoral Commission said they were supposed to bring their proposals and whatever recommendations they had for reforms, at least by the 22nd of September 2015. But following that also, a number of civil society organizations raised concerns and a number of pressure groups. One of those pressure groups, the Let My Vote Count Alliance, they convened or staged a protest last Wednesday, which turned bloody because it was marred by incidents of accusations by the police that the demonstrators and their leadership, they tried to break into barricades of the police and veer off the approved routes into sections close to the Electoral Commission for which they had not been approved of. And then following that, there were some brutalities for which even the police have been condemned for. But what do you make of the incident last Wednesday and thereof, so to speak?
Well, before I even come there, you asked for the reasons why we're in the U.S.
Okay, sort of.
I just wanted to touch on that, something. Mm. My wing, which is the Nasarawa wing, was actually very well represented.
And we said the Nasarawa wing, you are in charge of?
Of course, I'm in charge of the Zongo communities, the settler communities, and of course, a large portion of the three northern regions where we try to sell the programs and policies of the party to them to see how we can galvanize support for the party. In fact, we were actually not shortchanged. We were all part of the conference, and Nasarawa, for the first time, youth conference, Nasarawa was also well represented. We had a fair share. We must thank our youth organizer Samuel Oku and also the youth organizer in the US. If he's watching, Mujib, I should say hello to him. And the Nasara coordinator in the US as well. I know they are also always on your program. Alaji Turaki, Alaji Alino, and all those people, I thank them for the way, and Bala as well, the secretary, for the way they supported or they showed support for our program went on. Now going forward. Now what happened on Wednesday to me is sad, and we should not see Ghana going back to the dark days at all. Very, very sad. A demonstration or the right to demonstrate indeed is a constitutional right. And the little law I have learned and I have read tells me that organic laws can never supersede a constitutional law. Not at all. Organic law can never, never surmount or go beyond a constitutional law. Now, if you are hiding under some law called Public Order Act, okay, to visit protesters with brutalities, with mayhem, with beatings, with machetes, whatever, go name it, with all sorts of things, rubber bullets, hot water, and all that. And you're hiding under Public Order Act. Bear in mind also that there is a constitutional provision, which is Article 21D of the Constitution of the Republic of Ghana, that mandates each and every one of us to go on the street and demonstrate against whatever we feel is not going on well. Clearly, that is the way it's supposed to be. For me, I think that let my vote count. I have heard their leadership speak a lot to this matter. And I think that they only came out to go by what the law says. Indeed, the Public Order Act will tell you that go and notify the security agencies, herein called, referred to as the police, as it were. Notify them, let them give you the needed protection for you to move on. All they need to do is to protect you, to ensure they protect your life and property. That is the way. That is law enforcement. You see, I'm surprised, Roland, that you go to countries like UK, you go to countries like USA, right in front of the White House, someone is demonstrating. That is even a security zone, right in front of the White House. And you don't see people being beaten like the way we see here. You go to 10 Downing Streets in UK, you see people demonstrating, and police people are willing to mingle with them and dance with them even sometime. Okay, so long as they are going about it peacefully. Now, why should we have to visit what happened in 1979 again? Never again in this country should we revisit that. Why? Couldn't the police, even if granted that the police, say that some of the demonstrators veered off the route or the agreed route and all that, granted that is even the case, what are you supposed to do? You say there's a court order that tells you or tells them to go by this route. If you are to enforce the law, what are you supposed to do? It means if they veered off, the leaders are supposed to be held in contempt. Simple. They are supposed to be held in contempt of court. You are only going to make sure that you protect the life and property that you are talking about.
Okay, that's, we do understand all the point. But the point is, the police have consistently or incessantly said they had agreed on certain routes with the leaders of the demonstration.
Sure.
Okay. At the end of the day, they tried to break into the barricades and make entry into routes for which they had not agreed or were not intended to be taken.
I'm not sure. I have heard the police. I believe where we are told some of the demonstrators, and in fact, remember this, many are blind of the fact that, yes, some were on the route, you know, the people were many, and some were in front heading towards the house park. Again, we had some other people who were told had veered off and all that. Absolutely. Now, in veering off the route, I don't believe that police had barricaded the place, then they came to veer off. Not at all. If the police had actually barricaded the place, and of course no one was supposed to pass, and it was visible that here but I believe if there's a way out and somebody goes in, granted it's even so, like I said, granted it's even so, what they have flouted is the law, and it's contemptuous, and of course must be contested in court and let them be punished. But not
so they should take remedial action only after they had broken the ranks, broken the barricade, and made entry into routes they are not supposed to. Well, now let's watch John Boedo, and John Boedo is one of the leaders of the demonstration. He was also part of.
In fact, he was part of the demonstration. Let me correct this. He wasn't one of the leaders of the demonstration.
He was part
just
of the
as I was part of it.
Okay.
Boedo was
he
part
was just
of
a participant.
But let my
just like you.
Actually,
all right. So now let's watch him, and then we'll get back to the studio.
My biggest worry that we need to look at is whether or not, and I think we must test in the court of law. The police can have discussion with you if you want to protest, have discussion. Then a day before, they'll be hiding injunction in their pocket. They go ex parte and determine routes that protesters must use in collaboration with the courts of our country. I don't think it is fair, and that right of determining where protesters or demonstrators pass must not be given to the police and just the court.
Speaking about routes, were there attempts to use unapproved routes?
It doesn't matter. If somebody wants to organize demonstration, he has done all his publicity, he has sensitized his people, he has given them the route to which you do his demonstration. You hide. I thought that police are very strong people, they are bold, they will not be cowards. Hide and go to the courts. on expertise and determine a new route.
Last minute.
And you want the citizens rather to respect you.
Are you taking the laws into your own hands then?
We can't do that. That's why we've not started engaging in demonstration now. We'll go through the motion again. We'll apply, send the application to the police. We'll use all legal means to make sure that our citizens are protected.
So MPP will join 22nd demonstration, you will say?
John Buedu as national organizer will join. Yeah. It's not about MPP. And everybody that supports the new patriotic party that believe that there must be credible register must join.
And as the national organizer of the MPP, he was just a participant, we're told. And just like the national coordinator of the MPP here, almost like a quasi MPP activity, so to speak. But wow. But in the meantime,
I would disagree
indeed,
when you say it was a quasi MPP.
Indeed, he conceded that even if they broke their ranks or decided to not go according to the route they had agreed, because they had announced the route they had announced earlier, they thought there was a justification, so to speak.
You know what? Sometimes,
but that's not fair to the police, is it?
No. I think that we can't justify one any matter. I mean, any action goes contrary to what the law says. We cannot justify it. Fact is that there has been something coming from the court telling us that these are the routes we're supposed to go by. Now, again, fact is that some demonstrators actually veered off some marches veered off the route. And I'm saying, as a professional police body, as a professional law enforcer, what you ought to do is that primarily you have a duty of call, which is to protect life and property. They didn't say protect property, protect life and property. Whether or not the demonstrators, when they veered off, were actually going to destroy some properties, that's another matter. And I don't believe that happened at all.
Mm-hmm.
Again, the lives of even the demonstrator who veered off was even necessary, because you need them alive to even be in court for prosecution. I'm not sure that you will be actually be given a mandate to go kill when the people are actually not provoking you or not doing anything that is going to harm you. You understand? So for me, when the flag bearer spoke tough on this matter, that we are not going to sit down to be intimidated by anybody under this democratic dispensation that we have as a country. Look, let me tell you, it is an imbued or embedded right in us to walk out there and demonstrate against what is not right.
Well, nobody is disputing that.
Nobody is disputing it. But then the actions of the police, the brutality that they visited on the people is what is despicable, and we must not encourage it. Because let me tell you, going forward, if we should allow this to happen, the fear now is that, okay, each and every time that someone wants to come on the street to express, to ensure that
to express
his right
their
or
opinion.
To express his right, as it were, as enshrined in the Constitution, and demonstrate against a particular matter, there will be fears in the person, because he might not know what will happen to him. So what you should have done, now the police have told us that they have actually charged about 13 people to go take them to court. Now, if you knew you could do this, you had this particular thing to do, why couldn't you have just, well, professionally handled it? We are told by the law that, yes, you can, sometimes use reasonable force, okay? But let's ask ourselves, was this force that they used proportionate? It was highly disproportionate. Completely.
By what means?
Yes. As I speak to you, there's a gentleman who is, is one of the vendors of this call cars and all that on the street, who had a rubber bullet hitting the eye. The eye is destroyed. Whatever.
The gentleman whose pictures we see with blood oozing.
The gentleman has been operated on. The eye, we are told, is off.
Condemned.
Why do you do this? We are told the eye is off. You've damaged the guy for life.
Was he part of
the
demonstrator?
A 23-year-old boy.
Was he part of the demonstrator?
Whether or not, you see, these are the fears. This
what,
is the
was
fear
he?
Of, yes, of course. I'm told he was
okay.
part of it.
Okay.
And all these things happen. I think there has been a lot of brutalities. I have a friend, Opie. When you look at graphic online pictures, the way a man, a policeman is stepping on him and all, I said, why should you do this? What's so criminal about this? You see, honestly speaking, I think that the time has come for us to ensure that our police body are indeed spoken to very well. They are indeed, really, not all of them, actually, trust me, it's very wonderful, they are doing a good job, they've always been on top note. Yes, sometimes we have some skirmishes coming up, but then they should also try to control themselves a little. They should try as much as possible to control themselves. It's sad, it's very sad, and it's not something we should actually countenance at all, not at all.
Okay, at the end of the day also is the fact that the alliance wants still to get onto the street. They feel that it is important they present their petition to the Electoral Commission and its officials.
I'm not sure the law bars anybody from continuous demonstration. I'm not sure. The law tells
well,
you.
Well, as far as I know, no.
Absolutely. Yes. So fine. So even if they serve notice or they have actually, I listened to their press conference yesterday when they said that by 22nd of this month, they are going to go ahead again because they thought that they didn't actually finish their business. Their main business was to present a petition to the Electoral Commission demanding for a new voter register. And of course, because of this, botch one that they had by the police coming in and clashing with them and all that, they think that it is proper for them to reconstitute or come out together and reorganize and come on the street peacefully again peacefully, according to them. I heard David Asante, who is my very good friend, saying that, look, they are going to embark on a very peaceful demonstration. You know what? I heard one of the policemen interviewed on radio. It was pathetic. How can you say that even your hands, that the demonstrators saying that they were not holding anything, that don't they have hands and legs? Even your hands and legs are arms. Can you imagine this?
Mm-hmm.
How do you say this? So I should cut off my hand when I'm going to demonstrate? Because somebody will think that my hand is actually an arm or a weapon? I mean, you see, if we have professionals talking like this, we have a problem. So for me, we should not revisit what has happened in this country. In the dark days during the revolution should not be revisited. 79.
You think that was what happened?
Exactly what happened is what. Is it no wonder that some people actually have been groomed out of this culture? So it is in them, okay? And they want to use that to intimidate people.
Well, we do understand your point, but yes. We're talking about the police, and the police and its leadership, they've come out to justify the type of force they use, what they did, what they had to do, and even created a justification that the leadership of the demonstrators did not obey what they had agreed with the police early on.
So
at the end of the day, an agreement is an agreement.
So police who pass sentence on whatever has happened. What I'm saying is that, yes, the law says reasonable force. So to have gotten someone to lose the eye is reasonable force. To hit someone with a bullet, you shoot, and the person loses the eye, is reasonable force. That's interesting. I'm surprised. To have gotten horse whips on people, to have lashed people, to have whipped them and get marks on them is reasonable force. When without provocation, is that reasonable force? My good brother or whoever loves democracy in this country will not tell it's reasonable force.
And I'm sure very soon you'll be joined by Fred Agbenyo, who is the Deputy Communications Officer of the NDC. And he also will have his own thoughts on the subject. But it is, as you can see, an issue for which many human rights advocates have said is a demonstration which was not adequately managed by the police, but also putting also a blame on the conveners of that very demonstration. That's Let My Vote Count Alliance. And Fred Agbenyo has already joined us. Fred, how are you?
I'm doing, my brother. Mm. It's been a while. Eh?
Good, yes.
Yeah, there was a mess up in the time that they gave me. Yeah, so sorry for coming in late.
Oh, but that's okay. Yeah. You are one of our best friends, so we're very much happy for you. And good dress.
Thank you. It was very beautiful.
Right. What
the wife? The wife does it for
you. Oh,
him.
Great.
Your wife is a designer.
Your wife is a designer.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
What?
It's the same behavior the demonstrators the police beat them up. You've not asked him any question, but now see what they do.
But Fred, you are not saying because the police beat the demonstrators up, it was a justified reason.
I'll speak to that issue.
Okay. What do you make of the demonstration in itself, and subsequently what happened? And the answers you're getting from the police and the responses you're also getting from the conveners of the demonstration.
Well, Rola, let me say good morning to our viewers. I think that the 19th Constitution made provision for all Ghanaians to want to express themselves in whichever way, including demonstration. So to the extent that any Ghanaian think that is peeved by anything and wants to embark on a demonstration, I don't think anybody can stop him. But the law provides for that you notify the police, you and the police will sit there and agree on the rules that you use for demonstration and all that.
Which was all done anyway.
Please.
No, I'm just telling you.
No. Okay. Allow me. You know, so you are supposed to do that with the police. And as and when the police think that the two of you could not come to an agreement, they have the right, the law provides for that they can go to court, either go and seek an injunction or go and get some other guidance from the court. And all of us are supposed to comply with that particular directive. It's most unfortunate that people went back on a demonstration. Some of them went back home with bruises and blood and what have you coming from them. You see, Roland, I have a complete difficulty with this whole demonstration that was organized. It doesn't lie in me to determine when people must organize a demonstration.
Thank you.
But I think that
that's good.
The demonstration was needless, was useless.
Why?
Was uncalled for.
Well, anything now, that anybody wants to demonstrate, once it's justified, it can't.
No, yes, yeah, I'm saying that go. I cannot, from my perspective.
But that's your opinion. Of
from my perspective, I thought it was a very needless and a very useless demonstration, and I'm not surprised it ended up the way it did.
Oh, interesting.
These are a group of people who got up and said that, listen, the register that we have, they don't like the register. They said they want a new register. They subsequently petitioned the Electoral Commission. The Electoral Commission came out and said, all political parties, all stakeholders, come up with your proposals as to what we also think about it. Just last week, just this week, we in our party to have come out with our entire document. We have served there as political party. We have served Electoral Commission. We have served all the stakeholders. Electoral Commission has given up to 22nd of September for everybody to submit their lesson. Then we'll meet at IPAC to look at the way forward. If we are following this due process, what is the point in you going to organize to some of your boys and girls and say that they should move on the street and go and demonstrate against anybody or to go and picket at the Electoral Commission? Now you went there, they told you, the police told you that based on some security reason, you cannot go to that place. You cannot go to Parliament House that you wanted to go to. But these are the rules that we have approved. We have gone to court to restrict you from going to another commission and Parliament. However, you can use these rules, go to a house park and go and do whatever you want to do and go away. Don't forget, the police are there to protect the demonstrators. The police are there to protect others who are not taking part in the demonstration and all the properties around that area. We are not a lawless country.
So who?
We are not a lawless country. No individual in our society must assume that it's more important than the rest of us in this country.
And you're assuming when that's the posture that the demonstrators assume.
Listen to them after this particular issue. I've heard them on radio.
Well, they were brutalized.
Listen,
we've seen some of them being harmed.
My brother, you and I.
Did they attack anybody?
Can you allow me to make a mission?
No, don't
attack anybody. No, allow you. You have your turn.
You don't go.
Just a little patient.
You don't go. Demonstration. We are told by the police that they were throwing stones at them.
Oh, no.
They should stand and watch them because some people think they are more important. No. Some people think that their flesh is better. So they should throw stones at the police, kill them, help them. They should stand and watch them.
That's not true.
Because they're a group of people from the MPP. Is that what they are telling us? Even in America, the most civil democracy, if you want to put it as such,
that's not true.
In UK and the rest, when demonstrators decide to become indisciplined and misconduct themselves, force is applied to them. So nobody can sit in this. And I'm extremely surprised. I thought that their flag bearer, for instance, was going to come out to condemn what their boys did. That they refused to comply.
This is a fresh air group. It's not a political party.
Oh, please, Roland, you can tell that when you leave the scene.
Yes. Don't leave the set.
Don't want to leave the set. You can go and tell anybody that, but don't say that.
But these are not issues of the MPP, you say.
That's right. He knows it. I know it. Everybody else does.
Know what? I know what?
I'm very invited to my
has MPP come up
please,
and said
please,
that?
Please,
no, Roland,
please,
let's correct
please,
him. I don't know, I'm not correcting
please,
him.
Please,
MPP
please.
Has never organized it.
Why are you so impatient?
So I'm just only. No, I'm not being impatient.
So allow me to
put the records right. I won't sit down for
you've
you
made your
to
point.
Lie.
You've made your point. The MPP, this is not a demonstration of the MPP. Okay.
It's let my
you've made your point. You've made your point. Okay, Fred.
Do you understand, Roland? And I thought that the flag bearer said that, listen, I want to become the president of this country. We have lost. You are my people who are fighting the cause I am fighting.
No, but this is not an MPP demonstration. I want you to speak to
no, the point I'm making is this. If, let's assume that it's not an MPP demonstration, why is he speaking to it? Why is the party issuing a statement?
Because he participates.
He's a Ghanaian.
I'm coming. We know all the people. We know the organizers of the demonstration. We know where they stand politically. Like I said earlier on, their youth organizer was part of it. Their national organizer was part of it. Everything that they did, in fact, they did everything, organized, funded the program. This is not an NDC or CVP or any other social group that just means nothing.
It's not true.
This is purely MPP.
It's not true.
The founder of that group used to be the former TESCOM president at Tech. I know him. So this issue, why are you running away from your own people? Stand by them and defend them. Why are you running away from them? Why are you pretending you don't know them when they're your own people? The point I'm making is that this country will not sit down under the watch of President Mahama, under the watch of the Kenyan Security Services, for anybody to throw this country into chaos. Nobody is more important than any other person in this country. We are all equal before the law, and we must comply for our laws. So if any group of people think that it is their birthright to demonstrate,
is their birthright to
discipline.
What laws did he flout?
The police said they were throwing stones at them. The police said the rules that they agreed on that they will use, they refused to use that route. They were using other routes. Have they not gone against the law?
Well, they have.
That's interesting.
Yes.
And so if you kill them,
please. And you think that the police, as for the police, it is rubber that is flowing through their veins. So you can throw stones at them. Then they should stand and
but
watch.
But so far, it's not been confirmed. It's not been corroborated that
by who?
Oh, by the media.
I believe
that the foremost agency we can get the right information from will be the media personnel. I don't think that's the sum of the media personnel.
Go and take the tapes of most of the media houses that went to cover that particular program. Listen to Listen to the commentary that they ran on the issue. You can just tell what they were all about. We are not interested.
Did you listen to any commentary that said they were throwing stones?
I am saying that you go and listen to the
by media.
That's all right.
Why is this my brother so uncomfortable?
Who's uncomfortable?
Yes, not. This is not the first time. And I am surprised. People are just quick to condemn the police, saying that the police didn't act well. Is it the first time any police organized demonstration in this country? Not too long ago, didn't they organize a very massive demonstration in this country that flag bearer and everybody was in attendance?
Oh, now it's
did
massive.
Did we hear of anybody being beaten in that particular demonstration? Did you see anybody being slapped in that demonstration? So how come on this occasion?
So now we're having the police charging 13 of them, we're told.
Yeah, 13.
And that's justified.
And no one is charged for throwing stones.
I don't know what is this.
No,
choose even not to throw stones. You have gone to the police.
Look at what
the police and you have sat down and have agreed on the rules you must use for your demonstration. The police had agreed that you are not supposed to go to the commission and the rest. If along the line you decide to go to that particular place, the police have every right within the law to use force to restrict you. To use force to restrict you. So
say
you.
Nothing.
Oh.
No, I'm not talking.
What is all this misbehavior? This is the same way you misbehave towards the police and they beat you. You see, and these people come back on radio to come and tell us that. They are not bothered. Tuesday they are ganging up again. So I met one and told me, yes, the police should come. They are prepared for them. Tuesday they are going again.
They should go again.
I said, I met somebody. I didn't mention anybody's name. They should go back again on Tuesday. They should go and carry stones, carry cartilages, and the thing they've been near the party headquarters. They should carry those things again to the street.
That's not a very good
comment.
I am getting.
You see, there is a deliberate. And worker, where some of us sit and the things we hear and we know, that's what sometimes we get so frustrated. We speak the way we speak about issues like this. It's as if people have sat down and they have ganged up that will make this country ungovernable.
It's not true.
And that is what they've been doing from day one.
Okay, that's okay.
Roland, that's the way he has conducted
we
himself.
We refuse, and I sit here to say, we Ghanaians who are law-abiding citizens refuse to fall to the prey of their propaganda. He sits here and talk about people throwing stones. And I just told him, 13 people who are charged by the police, not a single person is charged with assault of public officer. Not one. If you throw a stone against or at a public officer who is supposed to maintain law and order,
you're saying that's an assault.
That's an assault, of course. It's not. It's battery to a very large extent, and you have assaulted, caused assault and battery, and not a single person is charged. So that means all that he's saying here, he's spewing out what we call garbage and lies.
You see, when you use that language, if you don't correct,
oh, you start.
Why do you say garbage? I spoke and said all I said is garbage.
If it's a lie, it's garbage.
No, no, it's a trash. So if I give him your own response, which I will,
I don't mind. Let's go on. Now we sit here in this country. People who have called themselves as revolutionaries,
behaving left, right, center, all over the place,
and of course, trampled upon the rights of people.
That's okay.
Fought people, put fear in people, in the name of revolution. Metamorphose themselves from
why you why do you
no, no, see,
why you keep going
you see,
you keep going back to revolution
when
no, I am
reckless what you are doing before
you came
you think you are going to tolerate people to see that and see look at this you are going to demonstrate that the police are doing with you now you are talking about where we are coming from we came from
beauty but be comfortable and listen to sense
Dango Abuja tradition
be comfortable and listen to sense
that's all right I have to say sergeant
and listen to sense
Dango Abuja tradition
I said
we know that
all right
Dango Abuja tradition
I'm changing the sergeant
only telling you your history. You don't know where you come from.
That two of you. That two of you. Fred and Kamal. Do I have your attention? Fred and Kamal. Do I have your attention? Fred and Kamal. Do I have your attention?
Please.
Fred and Kamal. Do I have your attention? I change the subject.